Hello guys, today's video will learn how to install and how to use the Substance Painter labeling with Houdini. So let's get started. Once you download the zip file and extract it, you'll find a folder like this one. To install the plugin, you need to open the Substance Painter folder and copy the HH Connect folder to the Algorithmics plugin path that is usually located in Documents, Algorithmic, Substance Painter, Plugins. Now, when you open Substance Painter, the plugin will be available, as you can see here. Inside the folder you downloaded, you will find a folder called Houdini. Open the menu.txt file and copy all the contents of the file. Now open Houdini, and in the shell, select New Tool. Click on the Scripts tab and paste the code. Then click Accept. To test if it's working, just click the new tool. To use the plugin in Houdini, you have to click the shell button we created. Set a port and click OK. This will allow Substance Painter to communicate with Houdini. Now, to use the plugin in Painter, first we need to configure it. To do it, we click the plugin icon in Substance Painter and a window will appear. At the top, we have a pin button. If clicked, the window will be always on top of the UI. Then we have the output path. Here we choose the export path for the maps that will be generated by Substance Painter. In software, we choose Houdini, and two new options will appear. One called UDIMS. If enabled, the texture sets from Painter will be treated as UDIM textures, and the materials created in Houdini will also be configured to work with UDIMS. The second will be the Houdini path. Here you need to define a valid destination to create a material network. By default, it's set to shop. Then we have a port. This port parameter must match the one we defined in Houdini. Then we have the renderer. At the moment, the plugin supports three different material types: Arnold, Redshift, and RenderMan. It's worth noting that if you're going to use RenderMan, you need to have installed the ArmanTree external environment variable. This is needed to create the text files automatically by using the txmake command. You can find a guide on how to install the variables in the description. Then we can define the export resolution, the file format, and the normal format. All the renderers use OpenGL by default. If by any specific reason you need a DirectX normal map, the plugin will automatically flip the white channel in the shader to get the correct results when rendering. Then we can choose to either use one texture file per material map or optimize the textures and pack more than one material map in a single file. For example, use the same file for the occlusion, metalness, and roughness. Finally, we can select the bit depth of the normal and hide map, and the general bit depth for the rest of the maps. To send the textures to Houdini, we have two options: either send all the texture sets, or send only the currently active texture set. In this case, I'll click Send All, and a new material is created in Houdini in the path we established. With the idea of keeping the plugin flexible, since there are a lot of possible workflows, the plugin requires for you to assign the material the first time. So we assign the material, and there you go, it's working. Now, if we change anything in Substance Painter and send the textures again, we'll be able to see the updated material in the renderer. Well, that's all for now. If you have any doubts or requests, let me know in the comments or via our Discord server.
Good luck!